What is up, boys? Another one back at you after that NFC Championship win against the Washington Redskins. Sorry, again. Gonna say it. It's technically in this game, so I can talk about this team. Hey, if Colin Cowherd can talk about the Washington Redskins on a YouTube video that is still uploaded 3 years ago, I think I can get away with it. But this is a very interesting team, this Colts team. Overall, pretty solid roster, offensive line, very strong at the center and guards. Defense, I mean, right there, Chris Hoban, part of that Minnesota front back in the early 2000s. You got Donnie Edwards, absolute beast on the edge. Patrick Surtain, Charles Woodson. Maybe we don't have the best duo of cornerbacks, but this is, you know, probably the best set of four cornerbacks you're going to see in the history of the NFL go up against each other in any matchup. And now we get to see it. You got Lawyer, Malloy. Hey, man, court is in session, fellas. As this Super Bowl is ahead of us against this Indianapolis Colts team after beating the Skins last week. 9-10, though. This Colts team has been on an absolute tear. 9-10. This means that I believe to start, and think about it, fellas. It's not like they're 9-7 and three losses. Think about it. I know it looks that way and it's weird, but this team made the playoffs. I believe this team was 6-10 and won their division. They've won three straight games of 6-10. Again, when you kind of think about 6-10, that's just batshit crazy. But you do have the Seahawks, who were 7-9, and ended up beating the Saints with that historic run by Beast Mode Marshawn Lynch before they became quite the almost, I guess you could say, dynasty, just at least for the defense, though. The defense had themselves a great stretch of years, but there's Chris Hoban right there. Don't worry, we have quite the offensive line to deal with him. It's going to be that man right there with his hands full with Matt Burke if he's going to run up the nose, as line up as the nose. If he wants to do a three technique, he's going to have to go up against either one of Brian Waters or Dan Neal, trying to shove it down his throat in the running game. It's going to be quite the matchup against this Colts team. This Colts defense is very solid. You can see why they've been able to somehow sneak their way into the playoffs and then just pull off three straight wins. Are they going to be on their way? We're just going to have to see. This is one hell of a Falcons team going up against what was a 6-10 Colts team to end the season. But let's talk about some basketball. Celtics somehow end up pulling it out against the defending champions, Milwaukee Bucks. Giannis having a little, okay, Quaker Lube or whatever the fuck that wing place is. I remember on like Wings Paradise or something on Travel Channel when they would have those. You remember those Paradise shows? They would have like Pizza Paradise, Steak Paradise, you know, Deli Katessen Paradise, where you see all the Jewish people eating pickles and what other items that go with a nice pastrami on rye. In this case, you would see it on the Travel Channel. It's Quaker Lube place, famous wings place, that I guess is a chain now in the Northeast. Ooh, interesting pass right there to Mr. Kelly Campbell. And then we have our own beast of a nose guard, D tackle, and Mr. Griffin. Beautiful catch right there by Chris McAllister on the interception. Down 7-0. But what can this team do for you? And what a nice play, Campbell. If that was maybe, just a bullet pass, beautiful run. Or more so a beautiful truck to buy himself 5 extra yards. Another truck, but it's just not going to do. It's going to lead to a 4th-and-1. And Mark Bulger ends up getting the turnover on downs. You got easily the best kicker in all of football right now, Jay Feely, who it's hard to say that he's going to be feeling it when the man's just staying cold on the sidelines. Could have gotten 3 points right there. It's going to lead to a 10-point swing after that turnover on downs. But Giannis, after the game, is pretty much fed up with how it was. His team ultimately just crapping it out, not doing very well, crippling underneath that Ime Udoka-led Boston Celtics team. Who, hey, that's another Greg Popovich, pretty much I'd say alumni of his school of thought, his school of what he taught, Mr. Greg Popovich, just extending the tree that has taken over this NBA with the likes of. And then you see Ime Udoka end up having a better scheme than a Mike Budenholzer, and maybe it shows that he's a better coach. Just got Giannis right there, and Giannis has done really well. Obviously, in his career, he's well on his way to a Hall of Fame career. And looked like he was well on his way to possibly an MVP again this season, but Jokic ended up getting it. And then maybe an NBA championship, but it's not going to happen this season after they end up losing two straight. So the man was just completely fed up. And, yeah, just batshit stuff happening for that Bucks team to lose to the Celtics like that. But, yeah, Giannis and the boys go down, lose to a Celtics team in which, okay, let's just don't overhype too much. Hell of a series by them defensively. Really schemed well. And really, that team's just athletically sound. And, you know, everybody talks about Marcus Smart and shit. That team wasn't doing jack shit for the most part. They're beginning their run, but I don't think this team defensively is the same unless they have the likes of a Derek White, who got traded from the Spurs over to the Boston Celtics. A dude that's just going to step off the bench and get a dunk. Because mind you, Marcus Smart was that bench player for them when Kyrie was out. Or just at least when Kyrie was on the bench. What a game so far by LaDainian Tomlinson. Even though we're down by two touchdowns, getting a lot done. Jeremy Shockey's there. That should be a fucking face mask. Whatever, though. Trying to get points at the end of this half. Wonderful move. LaDainian Tomlinson again held up behind the line of scrimmage. Buys himself seven. And that almost gets picked off. Now we see Jay Feely. It could have been 13-21 after this field goal. But that one's going to get put through. Just, hey, softly kicked. And it's just more about the fundamentals. This is going to put three through the uprights. But with the Celtics, I mean, Derek White. Derek White has been rated as one of the top guard defenders in all of basketball. He's very good at team defending, just at his size too. He's not ginormous for two, but nowadays when you see kind of like the likes of like how a Monte Ellis, it's kind of sad for him that he wasn't playing an era like today, because I feel like Monte Ellis could easily average 25 points a game in this kind of game, to where he could play, you know, the two at his small stature compared to, you know, just your stereotypical like Kobe Bryant at 6'7 or so. Monte Ginobili was 6'6. Just him and like the likes of just like a Steve Francis. But you got great size by Derek White. Obviously athletic enough to where he can move laterally as one of the best just perimeter defenders in all of basketball. What a move right there by LT. One of the best perimeter defenders in all of basketball. I think it helps big time because also, too, he can be a shooter off to the side to shoot the three. And he can also run the point just in case, you know, Smart is out, obviously. And let's say, you know, he's a guy that can come in and run the point if Smart were to get injured or something like that. God forbid, but that's just the case. I mean, it's ran up well. He knows Ime Udoka from times playing with the Spurs. Feel like that's just been a really underrated achievement that front office did for the Celtics. And I think it just goes to show how little some of these fucking dudes just on TV talking about sports. They're all talking about Marcus Smart and stuff. And yeah, you know, credit is where credit's due. It is. I mean, whatever. It's just, but overall, this defense, man. I mean, what an addition by Derek White. They just don't talk about it. This man, for sure, though, terrible fucking fumble. Jeez, just some bad mistakes right here towards the end of this game. This Colts team, man, is fucking fighting. But just really, Derek White, great addition. Guy can run the one and two at his size, and easily one of the best defenders on the perimeter in basketball. And it's only helped that team with the likes of Al Horford, Jason Tatum, Jaylen Brown. Obviously, Marcus Smart is known as a great defender on the outside as well, but I think Derek White's even better than him, so stop fucking giving the man credit. Or stop giving him so much credit without mentioning Derek White. But now you see, too, now we're getting the Luka Doncic, Larry Bird-type performances here in the playoffs, to where he's solidifying himself as probably the best scorer in all of basketball. It just kind of seems that the way he's been, Jesus Christ, Jeremy Shockey, fucking save some for the rest of us. Just Luka just started off the series just unguardable. You knew he wasn't going to be guarded well anyways. I know Chris Paul has been known as a great defender throughout his career, but the man is, you know, of old age and whatnot. He's just not going to be nearly as productive. That's why you need the likes of a DeAndre Ayton and Devin Booker to step up. And really, though, that's just like, you know, the Suns might have a great record for the regular season, but when you get the likes of a Devin Booker and DeAndre Ayton, both are just dog shit fucking defenders, in my opinion. Stop saying that, you know, the Phoenix Suns have a good scheme and stuff like that. They do have a good scheme. They've been able to just convince everybody and their brother that they're somehow amazing at defense. No, they're not. The Celtics are. And then DeAndre Ayton is too soft in the middle. And then Devin Booker, you know, the man's going to be able to put up 30 for you on any given night if he has enough volume, obviously. But, it's, you know, let's just say his offense isn't good enough right now to overcome his defense. And we're saying that, you know, with the expectation that he's been to an NBA Finals. They found themselves nearly on the verge of making it to the conference finals yet again. And, yeah, just I don't think their defense is good enough. I just, you know, Cam Johnson to them, it helps a lot when a lot of the attention's on the other three that I already mentioned with CP3, Booker, Ayton. So those guys will get theirs at times like that, but, you know, it's just overall. Shows you how good Luka is. I do think that overall Luka is the best player in the NBA. I know Giannis is just nearly unstoppable and whatnot, but just the amount of work that goes in with Luka to now see how well this team functioned at the end of that series, to be able, just what a play right here though by Mark Bolger. Oh, just moving in and out of that beautiful pocket. Nice little play to LT. Could have been a big run had he held on to his fucking block. Whatever. Time's a ticking. But, yeah, now the Mavs find themselves on the way to facing Golden State. And it's not like Golden State is the same Golden State as you've seen before. I know they're unique compared to before, but I don't think it's nearly on that, you know, level as being nearly as strong the team as they were in the past in their early dynasty. So I think with that being said, Jesus, what a bullshit fucking play. But there you go, fellas. Colts won themselves. Hey, they didn't finish the season with a losing record. Win four straight games. That includes right there the wild card, divisional round, NFC championship, AFC championship, and then the Super Bowl right here against our Falcons. Our Falcons are not able to win one here. It's a shame. I think we're a better overall team, but Mr. Thomas, he's just, you know, I think a 2 or 3 year player. Already won himself a Super Bowl. Later, fellas.